The universe is built on opposites. Sun, moon, night, day, fire, water, life, death. And even though I understand all the chemistry of it all, sometimes the contradictions like really piss us off, you know?
Like how they hate how we live but give us false education. Got a lot of land, a lot of people still begging. Artificial like sheep and Reagan. Who's to blame
Swaps
for taming? You
from Zana's working? Descendants. Really. Would the 50-year-old Korshnev Neanderthal theory be born out or thrown out?
The results from the Neanderthal DNA test were that all of the six descendants of Zana had the same amount of Neanderthal DNA as everybody else, about 2.8%. So we can say without fear of contradiction that Zana was not a Neanderthal.
It's a definitive answer. The faces in the room were impassive, hard to read. But the big news was yet to come.
Having got the results back on the descendants, I went back to have a detailed look at the DNA that I got from Kravitz's tooth. And sure enough, that wasn't Neanderthal, as that wasn't unexpected. But what was unexpected was that when I looked at the detail of her mitochondrial DNA, it was Sub-Saharan Africa. Sub-Saharan Africa.
Though Perkalov says it all makes sense, it's an extraordinary result. Burtsev looked pensive, as Brian explained that the DNA from Quit's tooth showed definitively that his mother Zana's maternal ancestry was sub-Saharan African. That means south of the Sahara, black African. But what did the DNA of her living descendants show?
So then I thought, in that case, perhaps I could find African DNA in the descendants. All of them have got sub-Saharan African DNA in their genomes in about the right proportions that you would expect from the result. Zana was 100% sub-Saharan African.
Suntans and racism. We are truth mixed with fiction. We are non-organic entities. Pure spirit and robot bodies. The wisest walk in rags. Sometimes it hurts to laugh. Half worn, half halo. It's most beautiful, it's that way. Check it, I'm a contradiction. I'm a contradiction. Yes, I'm a walking contradiction. A walking contradiction. I'm a contradiction. I'm a contradiction. Yes, I'm a walking contradiction. But I will contradict that. I'm a walking contradiction, yes, I'm a contradiction. Addiction, 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 addiction.
But Brian had spent some of the night before carefully examining Quit's skull and noticed some unusual features. Very wide eye sockets and an elevated brow ridge that could suggest ancient as opposed to modern human origins, and he was starting to toy with a thought-provoking alternative notion.
Maybe she isn't an African of recent origin at all, but one from a migration out of Africa many thousands, perhaps tens of thousands of years ago, and that she comes from a relic population taking refuge in the Caucasus Mountains, whichever explanation is the right one. And maybe there are some we haven't thought of. They're all going to be pretty unlikely, but they must be true somewhere. There must be an explanation for that 100% African DNA in Zana herself.
It's a radical thought, but it strikes a chord with Dr. Burtsev, who recalls the excitement of a Moscow anthropologist when he first showed him Quit's skull several years ago.
When he saw that skull, he was just just astonished that there is an association of very primitive features of this on this car and very progressive features.
This mix of primitive and modern features is intriguing. But could Zana really have been a relic of an unknown branch of Homo sapiens from an early migration out of Africa? It's possible. Understand the math really how it's sorrow so heavy when shared by so many. Is it volumes times math with times height?